Hey guys, and welcome to a new video! Today I want to present to you the build that I've been playing in the past couple of days on stream, and I think, personally said, it's one of a very decent and cool build. I'm talking about an Impale, Cyclone, slash Bleed, whatever you call it, mbX Gladiator. So basically the base idea is a Cyclone Gladiator with a lot of fine tuning and min-maxing on the upper side. This is not a typical build guide where I just show a map showcase and then talk about what gear I have and so on. For this build, the current version that I'm using here, path of building link is in the description below if you're wondering what I played here with my setup here and so on. But I want to more likely talk about the build itself, how everything came together from the base idea of playing a Cycloner, how I got the idea of going max block with the explosion chest, how could I fix my frenzy and endurance gain, and so on. Like, all of that stuff I want to talk about today in today's video. And maybe you learn some new things about designing your own melee character or character in general. So for that reason, I'm just like, just really going to unequip the whole character. I know already the comments like, hey, Savior, 15 exalts, hey, Headhunter, 100 exalts, hey, Paradoxica, I don't know how many exalts. Fuck this shit, okay? I really want to go over the basics on how to gear your character and what were the aims of my build, basically. And since I'm now done with the build, I mean, it's not entirely done. There is a lot of things, like if I just show you here my info box that I have running on stream. We still have, like, I want to reach 5k life with it, 75% max block, then 10 million Shaper DPS, plus 3 range gloves, then I want Tailwind Elusive Boots. So there is so many more things that I would like to adjust, but sadly, I didn't really make a lot of currency in the past couple of days, so... You know, I'm usually playing a build for like 2 or 3 days and then I switch to the next one. This build I played for a week and I really, really enjoyed it. So I want to give you the actual build guide, or at least like how everything came together. So if you want to min-max this build even more to make it even stronger, then here are the tools to do so. I've done a lot of alt content with this one, whether it's Shaper, Uber Elder, I did Lich. I sadly didn't found an owl yet. I pushed Delph with this build. Like I started on like 200 Delph. I'm currently on close to, or is it, close to 400 actually, so the next node would be actually 400. I'm currently level 95, which is the highest character that I've been yet. The other ones, like the Occultist, the Trickster, they're 93. This guy made it to 95, means that it's actually quite tanky. So, we started the basics. What were the intentions to do so? So, I wanted to build that can use a headhunter. You know, I have a headhunter, I love to play with this thing, and there is a couple of builds that go very, very well with the headhunter, with that being Cyclone. It's just right click and profit. Then you have Blade Vortex and other builds that are kind of nice with it, but this is not a self-cursed temp chains build where it's all about the headhunter, okay? So if you don't have a headhunter, absolutely no problem. The build will be the same or better in bossing, but less effective in mapping because you're going to be a little bit slower, because if you steal a haste buff with Headhunter, you're just going to speed up so heavily. But as I said, the main intention was, first build idea, I want to have a build that works well with Headhunter. And Cyclone, right click, as I said, whatever buff you get, you just right click, you profit, you're fast, whatever speed you get, it's insane. Good. The next thing that I planned is, okay, what type of Cycloner should it be? You know, there is a lot of ascendancies that you can choose, with that being, I don't know, like Berserk, you can go like Slayer, like Champion, since it's an Impale character, it's a pure Fist character. You can take Raider, you can take like Sion, there's so many options to go through, but I fell in love with the Gladiator since the rework in 3.7, with all the changes to the, I think it was 3.7, with now the Arena Challenger charges, with the Bleed Pops, with the Max Block, with the Outmatch and Outlast, and so on. I think like this is a pretty solid choice Gladiator here. A lot of speed and a lot of defensive mechanics. If I choose Berserk, for example, it's even more speed, more DPS, but I think in Metamorph League, Berserk is kind of rippy, you know? Berserks don't really have a lot of life. They have huge DPS, don't get me wrong, but very few defensive layers. This layer, for example, has Overleech, which is super strong, but if you ever play Gladiator with the Challenger Charges, once you have 10 Challenger Charges, which is basically in the first pack you roll into, you're gonna have 20% more attack speed and more movement speed. More movement speed, not increased, it's more movement speed. So you're gonna be fast as hell. And if you ever played with the arena challenger charges as a gladiator and then you swap to a slayer, you feel like a turtle. Because you're not fast, you know, and since I lack fast builds and I like fast mapping with spawning the conquerors and so on, I said, like, you know what, my choice is going to be the gladiator. Champion would be also same weight as the slayer, you know, it's not really fast, but you have a lot of damage through the adrenaline and the impale, but therefore, you know, it's still super slow. So my personal opinion was either the berserk or the gladiator. Whatever melee ascendancy you pick, everything has the advantage and disadvantage. Alright, so, I made the decision, I go Gladiator because of the fast clearing speed and the bleed pops. So that's that was the start of the character with the arena challenger charges going outmatch and outlast and the bleed pops. Means when I bleed enemies and I kill them, they explode, dealing 10% of their maximum life as physical damage, which then can get to a chain reaction pretty much, and you're gonna clear way faster. It's not necessary, but I personally think builds with a pop mechanic in, like the gracious violence here, or like impulse is like the lightning version of like pops and so on, you know, those builds are fast and fun to play, at least from my side. Okay, so this was the first state. We had arena challenger charges and the bleed pops. Then I was like, hey, I'm a gladiator. Metamorph is kind of rippy. I actually want to go max block, okay? So there are block notes on the Gladiator, and the most important thing is Painforged and Versatile Combatant. The Versatile Combatant basically transforms, or at least like gives you spell block based on your max block for attack damage, okay? So the only thing, if I have Painforged and Versatile Combatant, I only need to focus on block attack damage. And the same amount that I get from the block attack damage, I will also get for the block spell damage. So that's a lot of defense. The problem is, I lose my gracious violence, means I'm losing my bleed pops. Which is not great, but hey, if there is a problem that we can solve, we're gonna try it, okay? So the first thing I focused on was the Explo chest. So I use this one here. It's a self-crafted, it's a double influence. I wanted to have the Crusader base crit because it's a crit build and the base crit will give you a lot of DPS. And I wanted to have the Elder Hunter base crit, sorry. I just had a pretty long stream. We did some gambling sent here and there and a lot of farming. So sorry if I'm sounding a little bit tired and mixing stuff up. But you know, first work, then some good pizza. I just ordered one and I want to get this video done here. So, as I said, Hunter base crit, and I wanted to have the Crusader Explo mod, which is basically the same. The good thing is I don't need to bleed enemies anymore, therefore the explosions will do less damage, but it will definitely help your clearing. So, while I said, like, you know what, we're gonna go max block now and skip the bleed pops, I added the Crusader mod, enemies killed explode, dealing percentage of the life as physical damage. If you wanna know how to make chests like that, I uploaded a video about influence crafting a couple days ago. If you wanna watch that, feel free to do so. So we are now max block, or at least like blocking character with the pops. Super nice. Okay, what other things we have? We have outmatch and outlast, which has 25% chance to gain a frenzy charge on kill with your main hand and 25% chance to gain an endurance charge on kill with your offhand, which is a dual wield talent, obviously. And with Cyclone, you're basically attacking with both weapons anyways. So once you start killing enemies, you're gonna get frenzy and endurance charges. The problem is on kill. On kill is always bad. Why? Because if I'm doing Shaper or Cyrus now, or a Conqueror, I cannot sustain those frenzy and endurance charges because they're just on kill. And if there's only one boss here, no adds, how do I ever get frenzy and endurance charges? So I still wanted to make this work, just because we have the frenzy charges, 10% more physical damage, and if we are max endurance charges, we're gonna get 10% reduced physical damage, which is another layer of defense and offense, cause more damage, more defense through the physical damage reduction. There are influence chests. I think it was I'm mentally not sure which one it was, but it was neither Redeemer, neither Hunter, neither Crusader. So I wanted to have the Hunter base crit and the Redeemer, or at least the Crusader Explo mod, right? And there is a frenzy charge on hit craft on the chest with another influence, and there is endurance charge gained when you got hit recently, basically, right? So you get hit and you permanently sustain endurance charges. The problem is these are two different influences, and I cannot mix up four influenced modifiers in one chest. I can choose up to two and then it's about RNG. But since I have the bleed, the pop chest here, and I'm not using this talent anymore, I cannot really get anything which helps me here with the getting frenzy charges on hit, okay? The Raider Ascendancy would have that, a frenzy charge on hit, but I found another solution, and this is the Timeless Jewel here. So I got the Elegant Hubris. This one can have, or can roll basically, frenzy charge on hit, endurance charge if you got hit, power charge on crit. So a lot of these modifiers you can get with these. So what I did is buying one of these Elegant Hubris. They cost like 8 chaos or so. I bought a bunch of divines. I just divined it, put it in, and searched for the mod that's called Eternal Favor. So I'm going to here like put in Eternal Favor and Fervor, there you go. So what I do is I put this one, like I divine it, I put it in, I search for the stat, and once it shines up, then I check the other mods, because this is mandatory for me. I want to have this stat here 100%. If that's not there, no matter what other stats I can get here, it's useless. So now we have the blocking, we have the Explo, and we can sustain frenzy charges on hit, which gives us 10% more damage even on single target. So what I was doing is I was divining it, putting in, and then I see I have frenzy charge on hit. Oh, gain an endurance charge every second if you've been hit recently. So, okay, this is the base idea. You socket this one in, you divine it, there is multiple spots here, you can use it. I wouldn't really recommend it on this side because it will destroy your Impale node here, but you can try it over here and maybe over here, because if you get it on one of these nodes here, you can still take the whole life cluster in the top side, which I didn't choose yet, okay? Just saying. But this is the first thing. You check for this Eternal Favor. Once it lights up, you check all the other mods here in the radius, like Global. Here is another Endurance Charge. Then here we have Cold Resistance. But there is other modifiers, like I have with this one. I have increased attack speed. I have increased effect of non-curse auras from your skills, which is Pride, Flesh and Stone, all of these stuff here. This one doesn't get changed. Here I have the Endurance Charge modifier. Then I have 40 crit multi, 40 crit multi. Then here we have 40 crit multis, 120 in total, and increased melee physical damage. And this jewel here doubles my DPS. I did a lot of testings in Path of Building. Whenever I put this one in and set frenzy and power charges to yes, I doubled my DPS, which is kind of insane. You don't need to have a jewel like that. I had a total of 5 Elegant Hubris that had both frenzy and endurance charge that I sold on stream for people that want to try out my build as well. But this one out of the 5, this one was the best, so I took this one. Alright, so now we have the block, we have the Explo, and we can permanently sustain outmatch and outlast even for single target on Cyrus, for example. So, the next thing is, how can we get our block chance higher? The problem, or the main problem, let's just equip this one and I think my intelligence ring here. So we can just get in the gear one by one, okay? This one is just like either you have it or not, any Stygian Vice, any Elder Belt with life resistance, melee damage, whatever you can get is fine, okay? Usually, it's a rare item, so you get life resistance and you're fine, okay? Good. We can actually skip that because I just need the intelligence for the chest here. This is just a ring, complete garbage, just chaos spend for life and intelligence, nothing else here, right? Complete garbage ring. Okay, so now we're dual wielding, so we have a couple of options in terms of weapons. I picked up the Savior as the new item that is dropping from the Awakener. This is a pretty expensive sword. It currently goes for 14 exalts. It goes lower in price at the moment. So it's a cool thing to use. This is not a Savior guide, okay? This is just like, this is an item that I picked that I want to try out since it's a new item. How does it work? Basically, the short form, it makes a copy of your character and deals 50% of your damage, okay? And it uses your Six Link. Means if I crit with the Savior, I'm getting a mirror image, basically a reflection that also uses Cyclone with the Six Link. So as soon as the reflection hits a target, my reflection gets 45, for example, right? Which is not really necessary because the Savior is a minion. It doesn't count as a minion, but it has a life bar, but it cannot lose life, okay? So, whatever, basically. But you can have two reflections, and one reflection deals 50% of your damage, and if you have two reflections out, means you crit twice with a weapon, with Cyclone, for example, you're gonna deal 100% more damage. It's very significant damage for single target, but nothing else. And as my offhand, I choose to go with a Paradoxicar. Here it's just important to get as much physical damage as possible, and if you have the currency, attack speed quality, because quality will also increase your physical DPS. I'm currently having 196 DPS here, flat physical, and attacks with this weapon deal double damage. You can take any kind of rare weapon, just check if you have crit, attack speed, and as much physical damage as possible, depending on your budget. Before I switched to those two weapons, I had like, I was just going PoE trait. We can do this actually. You just go to PoE trait, and then you search for one-handed sword, for example. And then you just check for the physical DPS. This is the middle one here, because we are a fist scaling build. Obviously, you're gonna have the mirror tier swords here. But if you say, you know what, I have 5 exalts, what should I buy? Put in here 5 exalts and then just check exalted orbs. Then you sort by physical DPS. And you start here with 439 DPS as a corrupted version. It's not great, but then you check, does this weapon have attack speed? Yes, it has. Does it have crit? Sadly not, okay? So now you check. Okay, it should be about 400 DPS for the 5 exalts here. Sometimes you get a good deal if you scroll down here. So this one has legit like 10 DPS less than the first one, but it's 2 exalts cheaper. This is how you can get a very good weapon. So let's check what weapon would I buy here. Basically, what I'm looking for is how much crit does it have, how much attack speed does it have, because the physical damage is already sorted. So we're just gonna go down here and check if we find one that has both. Like here, crit strike chance, attack speed, more than 190 is super nice weapon, 5 exalts. Okay, you can buy this one or just lower the budget. And once you have the currency, you can try out fancy things like the Savior or Paradoxicus or any better weapon that you can actually get. Good. So, since we're a block build, it's now important to check what is dual wielding block compared to a shield block, okay? So, the thing is, if you are dual wielding, you get a base block chance of 15%. And if you think of a shield, you then have like 25% block chance, 27% block chance. You can even craft block chance on your shield. So, that means that getting block chance with a shield is way easier. I currently have 56% block chance at my current version, but I know with like an anointment, for example, like a Gemini, for example, or if I scale into the Fatal Blade, you're gonna get a lot of block chance while dual wielding or holding a shield, okay? And don't forget, with the Ascendancy, this one here, chance to block attack damage plus 8 if you're damaged by a hit recently. So you don't really need to be 75% block. If you have a little bit less, it's totally fine, because as soon as you get hit and you restore your endurance charges, you also gonna get 8% block attack damage, and through the versatile combatant, you're also gonna get 8% block to spell damage. So one good thing here is we have the jewel called the Red Nightmare. It's pretty cheap, it's like 60 chaos orbs. What you get here is passives granting fire resistance or all resistance, also grants chance to block attack damage at 35% of its value. And if I socket this one into here, that's why I took all the resistance nodes that are following around here, even diamond skin, because without this one, it just gives me all resistance, movement speed, and armor. If I socket this one in, I'm now getting chance to block attack damage, chance to block attack damage here, here, on those two. And even on the barbarism here, and since this gives me fire resistance, it's also a couple percent of the block chance. So the only thing that we need to focus on is scaling our block to attack damage, because naturally we're gonna get the same amount of spell block with the versatile combatant. I sadly don't have enough strength here to equip this one. Will it change with this one, cause it's my stat belt? No, not even enough here, 275. Oh wait, it's about a dexterity, so we're missing like 10 dexterity. Let's take the amulet for now. So we can equip this one. And now you're gonna see we have a total of 56% chance to block attack and spell damage. And if I get hit, it gives up to 64. But my build is not min-maxed yet. There is no anointment on my amulet because this shit is just chaos spammed. I'm not even focusing on that at the moment. But as I said, multiple carries on Cyrus, done Cyrus myself. Like, I've done all content with this build, so the more min-max I do, it will just get even better. And my first Cyrus kill, by the way, I had 3.5k life. Because you have so many defensive layers here, with the infused channeling, which gives you physical damage reduction if you use it with Cyclone. We then could anoint the Soul of Steel that gives you physical damage reduction. We have the 10% less damage, less physical damage taking when we have maximum endurance charges, for example. So the more defensive layers you build into your character, the less life you actually need to sustain or stay alive. And as I said, currently level 95 means I'm not really dying too often with this character. Good. You could also use a Romy's Concoction here to increase the block and spell block of your character if you want to. Good. The next thing is we now have a pretty accurate chance to block with the possibility to get even more. We now can sustain our Frenzy and Endurance charges through our Elegant Hubris. We now have the Arena Challenger charges to get even faster. So what is the next thing that we can do is scaling Impale, for example. The way Impale works, I made a video like last league or in 3.7 explaining Impale how it works, you know. So the thing is you have effect of Impale that is increasing your damage. And once you have 7 Impale stacks, 5 you have naturally, 2 you can get from the Watcher's Eye with Impale. Currently goes for 25 Exalts or something, I don't even have that yet. But this would be a difference of like 40% more damage globally. It's insane how much damage Impale gives you. And since I'm not even having that, and already no problem of clearing all content, it's just nice to have if you can afford it. If not, it's not the end of the world. Not even I could afford it. I know I could sell my Headhunter and get some better gear, but no. Why should I? Good, Impale. You have more than 100% Impale anyways with the Dread Banner and stuff like that, so don't worry about that, but it's going to be an insane DPS increase. And I did some path of building work, and I know that with good gear, I could get up to 10, 12, 13, 14, even 15 million plus Shaper DPS while maintaining the max block if you can do so. There are mods that you can check on poedatabase.tv/us where you can basically check the influences, and there is, for example, the Elder Gloves that I wanted to craft that can give you the chance to block attack damage, right? Means there are several items where you can either craft or get chance to block attack damage through influences to maximize your block chance. Let's quickly talk about the chance to block. Why is it good? Why not? I would say the more the chance to block is basically a pure damage reduction. Let's assume we have 75% block chance. I personally say it's 75% damage reduction because let's say you get hit 4 times in a row, okay? On a normal character, like let's say 2,500 damage per hit. Like my character would get hit 4 times, it's 10,000 damage. And when I have a 75% block chance, I'm blocking 3 attacks of those and I essentially only get 2,500 damage. Obviously, if there's a hard hitting back and you're not blocking the attack, you're probably gonna get one-shotted. But we still have Fortify, we have Infused Channeling, we have the Endurance Charges, the damage mitigation. So it's rarely happened. It happened today in Delve once that I got really one-shotted by something, you know. But I still plan to get way more life through the gearing process because half of my gear is really good, half of my gear is complete garbage. For example, my helm, Chaos Spammed, you know. This is complete garbage. What is it? Like 30 lightning, 40 fire resistance, and crafted life. Nice helm. Not even an enchant on it. My boots. What is it? Movement speed, life, lightning resistance, and crafted life. Dude, legit, with 10 chaos, you get better boots than I have. My ring here. What is that one? Life, intelligence, mana regen, chaos res, complete garbage. My amulet, we have fire damage to attacks, lightning damage to attacks. I'm a pure fist build. I run brutality. I'm not even doing lightning damage, or I only do physical damage. Complete garbage. The thing how I play my build and the gloves are not that great as well. I got the +3 here with the Warlord's influence, but the rest is just life, nothing too special over here, and crafted weapon range. The thing is, I always invest a lot in single parts of the build, like, hey, let's buy a Savior for 15 Exalts, hey, let's buy a Headhunter for 100 Exalts, but some of my gear is actually so bad that I don't even mind scouring that item or just vendor it when I'm done with the build because I'm not even going to resell or try to resell because it's just a shit item, you know? And this is basically half of my gear is currently kind of garbage and still needs to have improvements. As I said, the amulet is so bad that I'm not even willing to throw an anointment on it, cause the amulet is like 5 chaos or less, so why should I invest 3 exalts for an anointment? So there still needs to be upgraded. So in terms of cycloning, it's always nice if you have absolutely zero mana cost. The way you can do that is either, if you say like, you know what, the Explo chest is too expensive, I'm gonna stay with the Bleed Pops, you can craft Delve Craft with Serrated Fossil, the minus 50 mana cost, and your Cyclone will be for free. Another way you can do it is you get, since a 6-link Cyclone will always be like 8 or 9 mana basically, so you can craft the mana cost of skills minus 3 on both of your rings plus the amulet, which means minus 9, so your Cyclone is for free. The way I solved it, I got an Elrion modifier ring. So this is, you can get this through divination cards or from the temple or from maybe Syndicate even, I'm not sure. But it's the total mana cost of skills. This is untouched, still a global modifier of minus mana cost. It's not about channeling skills or non-channeling skills, it's really flat. So as soon as I have this ring, my Cyclone is for free. I don't need to worry about the minus 50 mana cost on my chest. I don't need to worry about anything on my other rare parts. I can now use an Owl's Amulet. I can use a Mark of the Shaper or an Elder, whatever. Like, the base idea is now I'm free to go and play with whatever amulet and ring I want. But before I bought this ring, I had to take all three notes of those with the minus 3 mana cost to make my Cyclone free. Why do I want to have it for free? The thing is, the more attack speed you have, the harder it's going to be to sustain it. And now I can even run no region maps because I don't play with mana. Means when I have all my auras on, which is Precision, Blood and Sand, Dread Banner, then Flesh and Stone, and Pride, I'm currently having 4 mana, and I still can use my Leap Slam because I have it on my Blood Magic, then I can use my Warchief Totem, and I can Cyclone endlessly without losing a single point of mana, and I think this is a big, big quality of life, and you should definitely try to get your minus mana cost either on your chest, on your rings, or even the Elrion like I did. Just one item and all your mana problems are solved. And if you play with Leap Slam and Warchief like I do, then you use a Blood Magic, so these two will get for free as well, and you never have any kind of mana problems anymore, and you can do whatever you want and farm almost every kind of map tier besides the physical Reflect, as long as you're not a Slayer. Good. What else to talk about the build? As I said, this is not a typical build guide. I really want to talk over the changes or things, guidelines that I say like, hey, how can I do this? How can I do that? How do I get to this part? Hopefully it helps to improve your build as well. As I said, if you're interested in the combination that I used, my gem links and so on, the path of building link of my current character is in the description below. And since I know already that people ask me for the MTX, we're having the full Demon Parasite set with the helm, body armor, gloves and boots. Then we have double Dragon Hunter sword with the Dragon Hunter weapon effect, Dragon Hunter wings, fiery eyes and glowing red eyes that you don't even see here, the ultimate chaos effect, then we have the ultimate chaos footprints and the blood guard portal effect with the dark cyclone, that's the red one here, and I'm shining blue because of the infused channeling. Then dark immortal call, void ancestral warchief, the hentai warchief basically, demonic leap slam, then we have flesh and stone, blood and sand doesn't have anything, and 3x all my auras, whether it's pride or precision, is the invisible buff effect. Okay, I think the majority here, the message here, how I did all of that stuff. Oh, one thing I want to mention here is this jewel here. It's the Thread of Hope. This is the new jewel that drops from the Awakener. I have like all of these dropped already. So if we're gonna go over to my tab here, they can have different radiuses, okay? So if we pick this one up here, I mean, I cannot really put them out now. Probably can show you over here. It's just a block jewel. So you have like a small radius, right? Then you have the large radius, which is even larger. Then you have the medium ring. So basically you can divine orb the size of the jewel. And I took advantage here using it on the right side. This is the very large ring. And what this makes possible, you can skill anything that is within the circle here. Not in the inner circle or outer circle, it's just about the within circle here. That means I can take these 3 points, I can take those points here, I can take like here the 30 intelligence, I took the life node over here, and the Fatal Blade, which is an insane damage increase on the right side, and I could still be able to take the block nodes, which is super nice. So the way I do it, and what you can do as well if you want to, I created a Photoshop file, right? And this basically tells me, it was a lot of work screenshotting out of the path of building to see how it actually works. But in the end, what I did is I was taking all the 4 radiuses that we have from small, medium, large, and very large, and I put it on the tree here with the accurate size. So now I know, for example, if I put it over here, what do I need, which circle range do I need to, for example, to get the constitution node over here. And now I know, okay, it's the third one, it's a large radius. So if I put a large one in here, I just can grab this node over here. And then you can check what other nodes are in range, what can you get, for example. And you even can take keynotes like acrobatics or keystones. So it's a lot of playing around. I would suggest they are not expensive at all, you know, like, I don't know, price check. They are 4 chaos, so not expensive. I would just tell you, or at least like, how you say, whatever. I'm just telling you, get all 4 of these with all 4 radiuses and try to mix it around in your build, get it into the jewel slots and see what notes you could get, what could potentially make your build even better. I think I get 2 big life notes over here and the Fatal Blade, which is a big damage increase, and even the intelligence note over here, which is a perfect fit here without spending too many points getting the best out of the best jewels in notes in radius. All right. This is enough talking, enough struggling here with the video, because I'm actually super hungry and tired and I'm going to eat something and then make a break. Today was an awesome day, a lot of achievements done here and there. And as I said, hopefully this video helps you on creating or building your next character. Maybe you want to do something similar to this. And by the way, if you want to use the Savior, I would recommend it. It's a very good sword. Don the Crown made a video about it. You can use it with Flicker Strike, Cyclone, Fire Wild Strike. There is so many options that you can do. Even Spectra Throw, for example. It's a fun item. It's a lot of DPS for single target. You're not going to feel it too much in the mapping, because the saviors are quite slow, I would say, so you're gonna kill everything while the savior is trying to catch up to you. But if it comes to bossing like Shaper and they're just cycloning on the boss, whatever, even if you dodge, they're gonna keep on doing the DPS because they cannot die, which is super nice and insane and very cool for any kind of melee build. So guys, hope you enjoyed this kind of video. Thanks for tuning in, thanks for watching, and as always, see you on the next video.